Tonight we're talking about multimedia marketing. It's not what you think. When you think about multimedia marketing, the first thing you want to understand, marketing, by definition, is communication with a business purpose. So all we're doing with marketing is trying to communicate better. When we think of multimedia marketing, we're talking about different types of channels. Now, currently, when you think of different channels, you immediately default to social media. Whether you're on Facebook or Snapchat, how are you communicating on Periscope? What about your Twitter following? But what you really want to understand is each of those channels really still tend toward the fundamentals of interacting with your marketplace. Those are just new tools that will allow you to do old things, which is communicating with your marketplace. And again, once you communicate with a business purpose, now you're marketing. So you may look at it and say, you know what, I have 5,000 Facebook followers. I'm doing a great job. Well, not so fast. Are those followers tied into customers or prospects or referral partners? Are they people who can help influence the way you receive financing? Or are they just people who are aware of you? But you want to make sure you have value through your multimedia marketing. So you get back to the fundamentals of getting information to people where they are. So if I'm receiving information through a blog or a podcast, that's multimedia marketing because I want to read information in a certain context so that I'm now smarter than I was before. Or if you're trying to introduce a product to me and I want to make sure I'm seeing real-time users, maybe I will go to a Snapchat where I'm getting current information quicker in a more interactive way. Regardless, when you're using multimedia marketing, the idea is to be able to receive the information and communicate with your prospect or the target that you're actually interacting with. So it has to be bilateral. You want to make sure that you have the right tools to do it to solve the right problem you have. So you want to make sure you're attending to people's learning styles. Some people are more audio learners. Some are more video learners. Some are more kinesthetic learners. So if you're audio, you want to make sure you have the right sound bites. You have the right ideas being communicated verbally. If you're visual, you want to make sure that you can actually see a video, someone explaining the idea or how that product is used. If you're more kinesthetic, your multimedia has to be something you can actually touch and experience, taste, but you want to actually have that tangible experience with it. Most importantly, that why you are going to have multimedia marketing is that you want to make it part of your brand strategy so that people can experience it and connect it with you. The other is that you want to make sure you get across all learning styles. And finally, that you maximize the value. Because if you're using a marketing technique that doesn't communicate your value and doesn't really demonstrate your culture, then at that point, you're not connecting with the audience and you're not successful. Communicate, connect, and maximize value. That's really why multimedia is important as a marketing strategy.